my name is Dr. Padilla. I'm a professor in computer science and psychology, and I've been a professor for over 5 years. We are in the height of application season, and I wanted to give you my advice on prioritizing which programs to apply to for your PhD. It can be so confusing. There are so many programs out there all around the world, and it's hard to know what to prioritize when you're ranking and thinking about these different decisions. So I'm gonna give you the four things I think you should prioritize, and the order might surprise you. So stay tuned to the end to see the last thing that I think you should prioritize. Let's jump on in. Okay, the first thing that I think you should prioritize is the fit. And you won't be surprised if you watch my videos. I talk about fit all of the time. So there's two components of fit that I think you should think about. The first is the program itself. And there's a few parts to this. So when you're thinking about prioritizing the fit of a program, the number one thing you're gonna wanna look at is, does a particular program that I'm getting a PhD from ultimately going to lead to my future career goals? If it doesn't, don't apply. Sure, you could do a PhD for fun and, you know, more power to you, but if it's not helping you achieve your ultimate career goals, don't apply to that particular program. Now, that can be very tricky because oftentimes you'll find that these programs will be exciting for other reasons. Maybe they're in an area that you love. Maybe there's a particular professor that you love, but you don't necessarily want to go into their field afterwards. I am telling you, prioritize your career outcomes. The whole point of this exercise is to get you your dream job. So if it doesn't help you achieve your career outcomes, do not apply to these programs. So how do you actually know if it will help you achieve your career outcomes? A really good thing to look at is placement. Look at the recent graduates from that particular program, and did they get placed in the jobs that you want? That is a very direct connection between their education and their placement. I think within that, another thing you'll want to think about is the actual degree title. For whatever reason, the world is obsessed with the actual degree title that you get, so you should not dismiss this. I know there's definitely people like me who got PhDs in one thing and ended up in a different field, but that is the minority case. Usually people evaluate you on what the actual degree is. So if the name of the degree does not match the field you want to go in, do not apply to those programs. It can be great for a bunch of other reasons, but that will be a major barrier for you moving forward. And the other part of fit is faculty fit. You want to fit with your potential advisor. Most programs, there is a particular advisor that will be responsible for you in some degree. So you want to make sure you fit in terms of their research. And the whole reason why this matters is not just because of, you know, your enjoyment in the program. What tends to happen is faculty will kind of nudge you to do the research that they want to do and that they're comfortable and have expertise in. So even when you're, you know, discussing this with people and they might not have research that fits what you want to do, but they say, oh, I'll be open to these opportunities to do different research, they will still nudge you to be closer and closer to their research. So just make sure that the research that they currently do, have a background in, are the expert in, is what you want to learn. So you need to make sure there's a very good fit there. Beyond the fit of the research, you want to make sure that there's an interpersonal fit. I think what can kibosh a PhD is if there's a bad personality fit. And you might be able theoretically to do the best research with your particular advisor, but you just don't get along with them. So the research is hard and stressful, and it will lead to worse outcomes overall. So you want those two things. Does their expertise fit, and do you have a personality fit with that particular advisor? Now, when you're evaluating all of these programs, don't just kind of have these loose metrics in your head. You should be writing them down. You should have a spreadsheet, and you should rank all of the potential programs that you want to apply to on these individual metrics. What tends to happen, and what we know from decision-making science, is that we tend to use these heuristics or rules of thumbs when evaluating different possibilities, and they tend to be flawed to some degree and have to do with our emotions. So we tend to over-prioritize our emotions. A way to get around this is to systematically evaluate based on the same criteria all of the different programs. So I would encourage you to put together a spreadsheet, and as you're thinking about a particular program, rate them on all these different metrics. Like 1 to 7, what is the fit in terms of research with me and a particular advisor? What's the fit in terms of personality between me and a potential advisor? What's the fit of the program, etc. And then you can quantitatively evaluate across all of these different metrics that I'm about to tell you. Okay, the second thing that I think you should prioritize is funding. I think you need to have funding. Of course you need to have funding, right? But I think you should not apply to PhD programs that are not funded. I'm here to tell you, my friend, that you should not be paying for a PhD. Okay, especially if it's in a STEM field. It is very well understood that people pay you to do work within your PhD. Okay, so you will get some amount of money from doing either research on a grant or from being a teaching assistant in a class. And then the other part of your job is to take courses and progress your research. Do not pay for this opportunity. And I know that there'll be some programs that seem really exciting and amazing. Do not pay, do not go into debt for these things. Wait and develop your CV if you're not getting opportunities that are funded. Wait, do not pay for a PhD. Now, the third item I think you should prioritize is resources. These are the things that are going to be offered to you. And I'm here to tell you, if they're not available when you start, they will never be available. So in thinking about resources, you might need certain things to do your research. Maybe you need particular lab equipment, or you need access to particular populations, or maybe you need access to particular environments. Those things need to be available to you as easily as possible. What tends to happen is people might say, oh, you can have access to this marine biology area, but it's 3 hours away, okay? But that low on your priority list, you want it to be easily accessible to you for free, whatever resource that you need for your particular research. So again, rank these different potential programs based on access to those required resources for your PhD. Also within the category of resources is education. The programs or the individual required courses are something you should absolutely include in your ranking. Now, I've seen this happen where different people will go into essentially what looks like equivalent programs at two different universities, but the actual education they're getting is very, very different. And what you'll find is in every single department, they specialize in something. And it's usually based on just the faculty they happen to have. So they might specialize in a particular technique, specialize in a method, or something of that nature. So you will find in a particular department, they will have specialization. And they might have a lack of educational resources in some other things that could be very useful for you. So you need to look at the required courses, because what you will find is you will end up focusing on the required courses, even if there's other courses, because life happens and a lot will be going on. So you'll tend to just do the required courses. So make sure those required courses will ultimately help you fulfill your research and career goals. In particular, look at the technical courses that are available to you and how often they are available. It could be the case that there's some technical courses that are essential for you to be at the kind of the top of your field, but maybe they're offered once every 3 years. Maybe there's a single professor who offers that course and who knows what they are up to. So you want to look and ensure that those courses are offered regularly. If they are a required course, then you will know that they are offered enough for that requirement to be fulfilled. If it is some non-required course, you don't know how often that is going to be available for you to take. And the last thing I'll say about courses is, do not trust what the faculty say about the courses that they offer. They have a vested interest in you applying, so they will sugarcoat things. But the truth is that sometimes there's a course that could be available but isn't often, or they'll say things like, oh, I just learned this on my own. It's really easy to pick up, okay? If it is not a core required resource, it is not going to be available to you, and you're likely going to have to learn it yourself, go out of your way, find funding for that course in some capacity. So just ensure if it is central to what you want to do, that's a part of that core curriculum, the required courses. Okay, the last element that you should prioritize is probably the one you would think about first, and that is the human element. That is things like, am I happy in this city? Am I close to my loved ones? Are there the activities I need to be healthy and successful? And the reason that I'm putting this human factor last in your prioritization list is, if you don't have those three previous factors, then it doesn't matter if you love the city. If you have a bad fit between you and your advisor, you could have the best time in that city, be around all of your family member, and you still might have an unsuccessful PhD. So I think the first three are required, and this last one you want to use to pick among the options that are reasonable, okay? This should be the tiebreaker, this human factor. And when I say human factor, what I'm really talking about are the things that you would prioritize personally that would be different from someone else. And I think these are truly important. You have to be happy during your PhD, but I don't think you should prioritize them first, because it could ultimately lead to a lower potential outcome. So what do you do if you have some options that are high ranked for these other factors, but very low ranked for your personal factor? Like, maybe you would hate the city, maybe you'd be too far away from your family, something like that. I think that's a personal choice for you. But I would say, this is gonna sound crazy, but this is coming from someone on the other side, right? I'm a professor. 5 years is not a crazy long time. So dealing with something that is personally not ideal for 5 years to give you a longer term career success, I think that that is a good bargain to make. You can disagree with me and that's okay. But I truly think that it's one of these things where if you can go without some things from your personal life that will ultimately put you in a better position for your career, then you're kind of setting up future you for a better position than immediate you. You're kind of deferring these long-term benefits. And that was the choice that I would make. So this is my own personal opinion. Of course, you might make different ones and that is fine as well. Okay, those are the four things I think you should prioritize when evaluating these different PhD programs you could apply to. Again, I want to emphasize that you should rate them on a scale and then rank them in accordance with their particular scores. Don't just kind of go on vibes, because that will tend to mean that you will just prioritize a gut feeling, which is very, very biased in terms of what we know from decision-making science. If you found this video useful, please consider hitting the like button and subscribe for more content on academic success. Academia can be tough, but you don't have to go through it alone. Keep learning, keep growing, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care.